All right. Good morning, everyone. At the expense of sounding repetitive, I'd like to extend a warm welcome to all of you to our Bangalore office. It's both a privilege and pleasure to be part of this first India SearchMasters conference, and I hope that this is the first of many more to come. All right, thanks, Paul, for the small introduction as well. As he said, my name is Koti. I'm part of the search quality team. I've been with the team for a little over 3 years now. And out of the bunch of exciting things that I do at Google, one of my most favorite part is being part of this forum and helping out with masters, answering the questions, and basically building a solid community around it. And that's exactly what I'm going to talk about today. So moving on. At Google, we love webmasters. And I think Adam has put that point well across in his engaging talk earlier. Among the gamut of resources that we provide to our users, these are some of my favorites. Webmaster tools, right? It allows you to look at your website exactly as Google sees it. And that's tremendous information because it gives you access to some crawling issues that your site might be having with Googlebot and allows you to rectify it among the other tools that it also provides along with it. We also have sitemap tools. Again, Adam talked about how important sitemaps are. So we have a sitemaps generator on code.google.com. It's a Python script, and you can customize it. I'm sure most of you might be using it already. But what we also have are links to some third-party tools that we think are really good at generating sitemaps as well. Again, those are links available on our code.google.com link as well. So you would want to check that out as well. Yeah. The next one is brand new. In fact, we launched it a couple of weeks ago. We have our own channel where Googler guides around the world have put together some really informative videos about Webmaster and tips and tricks. In fact, we have two videos by Matt Kutz about the recent canonicalization issue as well. So you would want to check that out. Also, I would request you to keep coming back to that because we would be adding more videos in future as well. And we also have a 30-minute interactive tutorial. Again, this is the essential Webmaster 101, you could say, because it has everything what a webmaster would need to know before starting a website and how he wants to interact with Google. So you would want to check that out as well. And finally, we have our Webmaster Help Forum as well, which is what I'm going to talk about today. Before I talk about it, I'd like to take you guys back a couple of years on the timeline just to set the context about how we've evolved as a group over the years. June 2005 is when we officially launched Google Sitemaps Group. This was also the time when Sitemaps was a brand new protocol. Not many people knew about it. So we wanted to give support for that. It was not an industry standard as yet. We had support in two languages, and we had a few hundred users, again, primarily for the reason that not many of them really understood what the significance of a sitemap file is. So the discussions were fairly technical. There were very few Googlers giving support as well. But more importantly, the scope was limited. As this name suggests, it was primarily regarding sitemaps. And it was not really addressing the broader issues of indexing and crawling. And that's something that we realized. And in 2006 is when Google officially expanded its support charter. And we've come to be known as Webmaster Central. So a lot of things changed with that as well. Sitemaps groups became Webmaster Help group over there. And the Sitemaps blog became Webmaster Central blog. And a lot of good things actually transitioned in that phase. What also operationally happened is from two languages, we suddenly started supporting 15 languages. And our user base grew, obviously, because we broadened our scope. As I said, the scope was limited earlier, and now we started keeping an eye out for the general trends, but also in general addressing the issues of indexing and crawling as well. So our user base grew as well. And of course, we had dozens of Googler guides. So we have enough Googler guides working in each language help group as well. So user activity increased, and obviously we needed more Googlers to monitor and build the community around it as well. So we have more Googler guides as well. Remember, this was also a time when the web dynamics generally were changing so fast. Web technologies were becoming easy to use, and people with almost little to amateur experience were charting their own online experience, and hence it basically became imperative to us to kind of broaden our scope as well. And very recently, in fact, a quarter and a half ago, we've launched a new platform for our help group. So in fact, from the old school group style, we basically transitioned to the new forum style. So basically, what we call it today is the Google Webmaster Help Forum. So operationally, not much has changed, but from a technology standpoint, it's a huge change because, as I said, we moved from email listings, old school email listing types groups from to a new platform that we call the Webmaster Help Forum. And a lot of issues that were hanging around groups were basically solved by this transition. Issues like, you know, it was not really efficient in drilling down to your question, you know, finding answers to your questions easily. And also, as I said, it's extremely important for us to recognize our, you know, super users, as we call, or the top contributors who are building our community, reminding you that they are building, they're basically helping out webmasters around the world in their free time and at free cost as well. So we wanted a system that we could recognize our top contributors as well. So that issue was also solved, and we'll have a look at that as well. Currently, the status is that you know, it's in transition for the other 15 languages as well, but we've launched it in English and Polish, and you would see how it has actually hit the popularity charts. I have a slide that you'll like to see later in the presentation. So let's have a look at a new forum. Most of you guys know SitePro News. It's a popular technology portal. It actually quoted saying that from a sheer technology and functionality standpoint, Google Webmaster Help has taken a huge leap forward. And we're really happy that you know, this was one of our goals, and it's actually played out really well. Some of the features, I could say, of our new forum is a question and answer based forum. And as I said, most of you must have used groups before. It's really difficult for you guys to, or not, I would say really difficult, but it was difficult for you guys to actually drill down to search and come down to a question where you really wanted your answers in. So this actually changed because in the current forum, you can navigate and come down to, the search is better, and also you can actually navigate to the questions that have been answered before as well. So it basically becomes searching for your questions much more easier. And you have Gmail-like features and functionality as well, which means that, you know, for archived questions or your favorite questions, you can actually start it, and already maybe sometimes you can help out other users who have similar questions to point out to questions that have already been answered before. So basically, it's a much more efficient way when compared to before. And most importantly, as I was mentioning, user reputations are prominently displayed. And this is one of our top contributors. His reputation is clearly displayed in terms of his status, saying top contributor. Oops. Okay, I just need to go to the slide. What happened? Yeah, user reputation, as you can see, his reputation is top contributor, so we basically recognize people. So the platform allows people to answer questions, and users can actually vote saying whether the answer was best answered or not. And depending upon that, you can actually accrue some points. And the more answers your question, more questions you answer, and the more points you get, your status of reputation basically builds up. So this is one of our top contributors. You can see the questions he's asked against the questions he's actually answered as well. All right, so let's have a look at you know, the forum itself. And the reason I'm going to talk about the anatomy of the forum is to let you guys know what is the best way to make use of this forum, and we'll have a look at that. So this is how the new platform looks like. As I said, it's basically a question and answer format forum. You have a search box there. So if you want to search for questions, you have this high possibility that somebody already answered it. So you would just want to search for it and get your answers much more quickly. If you don't find it there, to the left, you have, again, navigational quick links. If your question basically falls in this certain domain, you can click through that link and you can get your answers much more quickly as well. You can also get your answers based on what recent activity improvement. We have Google gadgets. So previously, if there was any bug, we used to make a sticky post, and it used to be, you know, at the start of the forum. And if there was any escalations, there was not an efficient way in which we used to respond and tell people that this issue has been resolved, that this bug has been taken care of. So we have a gadget, Google gadgets, for basically announcing well-known bugs, that saying that, hey, we know of this bug and we have identified it and rectified it, or basically an issue which has been resolved as well. So this is something, again, from a technology standpoint, something has changed from the old model as well. So after all this, if you still have questions, the easiest way to do is just basically post your question. It's highly likely that you have something really specific, and we would like you to actually go ahead and post it, because that might be a burning, that might translate into a burning issue, and you basically are helping out other webmasters, know about this issue as well and help them resolve it as well. So after you basically make sure that you've searched for it, I would recommend you, if you don't find your answers, to definitely go ahead and post on the forum as well. All right, this was the graph I was saying. So if you have a look at this graph, this basically tells you the number of posts made on the y-axis against the timeline, which is basically a set of data for the last 24 months. The lower red dot is basically the point where we launched our new platform, which is the Webmaster Help Forum. And you see the user activity actually hitting the roof there. And it's, so again, something that we really are proud of, and that's exactly what we wanted to do, improve user base, get more users, and also build a community around, recognize our top users as well. All right, so time for some real examples, some success stories, people who had questions, they didn't know what to do, they rang the doorbell of Webmaster Help Forum, and in fact, they found their answers quite quickly. So this was a webmaster who accidentally actually left sensitive client data. It was basically credit card information of his client, and he let Googlebot crawl it. So he obviously was mad, because he didn't know what was happening. He didn't know whose fault is it, so he basically was came to forum asking, I need a way to get this off the forum immediately. There are a couple of ways of removing your content from Google. There are actually two issues, removing content from Google which already has been indexed, or in fact letting Googlebot not crawl in the first place at all. But this was a case where he already got his content, indexed, and he wanted to remove. And the way we and what happened eventually is that he got to know that there's something called as Webmaster Tools that he could sign up for, and there's a tool within which he can, immediately expedite the process of removing that sensitive information. He did it, and he basically got that sensitive information down within a few hours. So this is again, not maybe a savvy webmaster, but we have thousands of them out there. And this is a platform which is giving a lot of value add to all those people out there. So let's move on to the next one. This is again another interesting one. This is a site of a church. What happened is that people were searching for it, and weird snippets were turning out. He didn't know what to do, really controversial snippets coming out. And so what he did is he came to the forum and he asked, what's going on? So obviously, as you guys might have already guessed, this site has been hacked. And he wanted to know what are the best practices of, preventing this in the future, how to remove this content obviously immediately, and to how to basically build a more efficient and a foolproof site as well. And he got his answers, and he was again a happy customer. So there are various success stories like this. As I said, the user base is not only unlike the sitemaps group time, when there were experienced webmasters talking about sitemap protocol syntax and the general generation of sitemaps. The scope has actually broadened to a point that people with almost no experience, it might be a webmaster who's asking questions, or it might be the client, the owner of the website who's asking questions as well. So he might not have any idea about the basics of webmastering. So we are trying to help out and cater to all this audience out there. All right, moving on. Again, I wanted to give a special shout out to our top contributors. We call them the Bionic Posters. Again, all of these are experienced webmasters and extremely pro Google, but nothing to take away from the fact that they know what they talk. These are people who, out of only their free time, have helped out thousands and thousands of webmasters around the world. We have people from, you know, these are some of them. We have, you know, even more, and our target is basically increase more and more top contributors, or what we call them as the Bionic Posters in future, because essentially, it is not possible that, you know, every question is answered. And so what we want to do is basically build a community where people are answering questions to other people on the forum, rather than every time Google answering a single question. And that is basically our whole idea of recognizing these top contributors and you know, improving the dynamics of the community that we build as well. So special shout out to all of them out there. All right, so I thought I'll actually take a few minutes to talk about some of the frequently asked questions, but again, you know, a couple of them have already been answered comprehensively by Adam earlier. I think the only one that I'll take right now is the second question. So there were this is a frequent question about people buying domains, resell domains or park domains, and they don't really have an idea about what that site looked like in the past, and the question was whether, you know, it will affect my site at all. And basically, the crux of the question is, what is the best practices while you are, you know, buying already owned domains? So the answer is simple. You know, basically verify it through webmaster tools. Look at the backlinks of your site, if there are any. If you feel there are some unnecessary or irrelevant links, you would want to clean them off immediately. And most importantly than everything, if you still feel that there is some, this is some way affecting your position in Google search, it's always you know, good to actually file a reconsideration request, which is basically an option for you who thinks that I've done everything fine, but I still think that, you know, I don't deserve the position that I have. You know, you could file a reconsideration request, especially in cases of buying already owned domains, because it's not possible for you to know the activity of the domain in the past. There are very little resources out there. So it's always good to basically file a reconsideration request. We have a look at the site. We have a way in identifying in the user activity on that site before, and we would take action accordingly. But otherwise, the other questions were basically already answered. Geotargeting was answered pretty well. Duplicate content was answered comprehensively as well. In fact, the highlight, I would say, of today's session is basically the Q&A, because it kind of covered most of the frequently asked questions that we usually spot in the Webmaster Help Forum as well. With that, I think I have come to the last slide. Thanks again for all of you inviting our, accepting our invitations. A shout out to our webmastering community on Orkut. This is specific to Indian webmasters. I'd recommend you to go ahead and sign up, so that the turnaround time, you know, might be a little faster as well, because we are on lookout for questions, more and more questions on this community as well.